Sorry. I was supposed to do another poem, but I'd rather do this poem. I swear this is not a disclaimer, but the poem may be kind of hard to follow. So,
from the campus at DePaul University in Greencastle.
I swear it's not a disclaimer. It's the poem. The words don't always come to me like I'd like. I would like to say that they're fragmented miracles muddied in their own syntax. I mean, look at it. It's kind of difficult to explain, but with each line, the definition of the piece begins to mutate as if being itself is something it never wants to inhabit.
The beginning. Procured from ancestors whose reality was harder than I imagine, I adopted the struggle through osmosis. To ponder my origin is to acknowledge my feet still glued to the starting blocks as my peers dash down the tracks, allowing their arching souls to learn the contours and obstacles of this path. I fear my writhing fingers will claw out chunks of this earth as I abandon law and crawl to the finish line. The city has been such an inspiration, both like for my positive poetry and my negative poetry. I feel like observing the daily lives of Chicagoans has been like a very interesting thing. And I also feel like observing the ways that I change because of the city has been interesting. But like as far as the city, like I pull from the beauty of it, like physical beauty, I pull from a lot from like what we're known for most, which is like the violence, and I pulled like underneath everything, this is where I grew up, right? So this is where a majority of my experiences have been, and like this is pretty much where I center my poetry around. Like when I'm writing a poem about me, I'm writing about me in Chicago, you know. So this city has pretty much served as the backdrop for my work. I've always accepted that I didn't want to like go down the paths of others. Like I've had my moments where I've like dabbled in like life, like the street life, right? And I've definitely been in position to see that intimately a lot of times in my life. Like I've probably never lived in a neighborhood better than the one that I live in right now. And this neighborhood is all right in terms of like violence, crime, and all that. So like before this, like I've definitely had like a good amount of exposure to like the streets and all that stuff. And like I realized that that's not like as alluring to me as like doing something that could possibly like lead me to be successful. And so I've always had people in my life, like my grandma, my mom, who like told me to invest in myself, invest in like the gifts that I was giving and stuff like that. So I definitely feel like I always had like a good amount of pride in myself to like kind of counteract like any type of like negative stigma that people might have had about like me doing poetry or anything like that. This piece is called Home, and it's about the gun violence in Chicago. I started writing it a little bit after Hydea Pendleton died, because like the park that she died at, I actually like I was there like pretty frequently, so like me and my friends always talked about it as like it could have been us, it could have been any one of us. So yeah, this is a little something that I just wrote about like how I was feeling about the violence at that time. Chirac, this place is very, very scary. No tail fairy, bullets passing through broken bodies. Hail Mary. So I stayed to myself, confined solidarity. Streets are seldom empty after night hours. They're full of gun toters and night prowlers who bring about gang terms and lash hours, itching for an easy vic. It's funny, the shot that's heard is seldom the one that hits. So, is that your dream, kid? Then swallow it and cherish life before you're found lying in a hollow pit. I know it's scary, but this the life I'm accustomed to. You slumped a shorty for his custom shoes and expect me to look up to you? But this is Chirac drilling noise. Anything goes. Watch, clothes, wallet, phone. You got it, they take it, then they gone. Come summertime, it's probably safer to stay inside your home, as opposed to writing sentimental words upon your children's gravestones. Chicago is experience, trials, and forgiveness. The thickest part of the burden, rarely know things for certain. The hope that the future brings us was keeping us all from hurting too much. They all expect heroics till it's time to suit up. They never want the smoke, and I just guess I'm too blunt. I look up to the sky and tell God this is too much. He said, you're almost at the end, how could you give it all up? Damn, good question. My father's days were numbered, he taught me to count my blessings. I feel like DePaul is when I really has been like the space where I really come into my own in terms of like coming through with like a poetic voice, specifically because like I don't think I really performed as much as I have anywhere else besides DePaul, and that's been like really, really good because it's giving me opportunities to perform and it's giving me opportunities to like write to topics. So I think that just doing that practice and having that those experiences have kind of like vetted me in some senses. I feel like I was never really comfortable performing until I took public speaking my first semester in college. After I took public speaking and really like got a chance to perform more on campus, like performance started to seem natural to me. I started to see like everybody in the crowd is like my peers. So it like stopped a lot of the nervousness. I feel like every performance I have, like my feelings change depending on the crowd, depending on the subject matter, what I'm talking about. Depending on the energy I'm getting from other performers. Performing is such a like indescribable feeling, but if I could describe it, it feels like telling like a crowd of people a little bit of your story, and it allows them to like take away from your performance what they take away and make that kind of into their interpretation of you. So I appreciate performing for that aspect. I do think that the identity that I've sort of come into Greencastle, I bring back to Chicago, funny enough. I don't think that Chicago influences me more than Greencastle has influenced me, if that makes sense, in terms of me coming into an understanding of who I am, and I think that's just because of the time that I like started living here. Like I came to college when I was 17, turned 18 here, and really have, since I've been in college, come into adulthood, and I've thought about things and I've learned things that I've like never really thought about or learned before. And so Chicago was definitely molded like who I am down to the core as far as like my principles and my values, but Greencastle and coming to maturity in another state is definitely molded me and shaped me in a different way as well. So I feel like they, like, the two places that I really, like, have come into the big moments in my life have shaped me and like, affected me in different ways. But together, they both kind of worked to make me who I am. The end. Endings are nobody's friend. I mean, they remind you of mortality and reek like rotten fruit, the departure of sweetness and life. Endings are nobody's friend. They spread lies about possibility and gossip about opportunity. And when you confront them, endings will look at you as though they said nothing at all. Endings are nobody's friend. I would know. I've become accustomed to seeing everyone I love disappear when endings come around. Maybe their eyes weren't built to capture completion.
You never thought I'd make it this far, did you? You always had to make it hard for me. But I'm a star, didn't you know? Can't you hear that applause for me? My brother Eve told me some just wanna be safe, and some just wanna be great. Which one of you? Let's go make history today. Let's go make history today. Boy, use your brain, only your heart can lead. You'll figure your way, man, it ain't for me to say. I cut my love until my heart could bleed. I'm on the road, I guess it ain't meant for me to stay. But I'm here with you.